Hi, I'm Robbie Griffiths and we're here today at Heronbrook Fisheries on the Meadow Pool, and I'm going to show you how to get the best out of using soft CAD pots. So the soft CAD pots come in three different sizes. You've got a small, medium and large. And it's really important to pick the right pot on the right day. When you're feeding small amounts of bait, the little tiny pot's perfect, so a few micro pellets in the winter or a couple of grains of corn. Once you move up to the middle-sized pot, you can feed a lot more pellets, or you can start to feed baits like ground bait. And once you get the big one, it's really good for when you're fishing down the edge, so you can pot in a reasonable quantity of ground bait and corn, for example, each time you go out. I like to start the session normally on the small pot because you can feed a small amount of bait and kind of gauge the response from the fish. Then you can move up to the next size pot. So with a small one, if I'm fishing pellets across like today, I can kind of start off by putting 6 or 8 hard pellets in. And if I'm getting plenty of bites, I might stay with that. But if I feel I need to start feeding a few more pellets, then I might put the medium one on just so I can put a bit more out there and I can sit there for a little bit longer waiting for a bite. So there's three different lid configurations with the soft CAD pots. Firstly, you've got no lid at all. It's really, really useful when you're fishing baits like ground bait, loose ground bait. You can put it in there, just use your thumb to hold it in, and you can ship out there and it's not going to come out. And with it having a really stiff rim, it helps the pot to keep its shape no matter what bait you put in there. Secondly, we've got sprinkle lid. So for 4mm pellets, maggots or micro pellets, that's really good. You can put some in there, you can ship your pole across, tap a few out and then start fishing. If you haven't had a bite within a few minutes, you can repeat the same thing without shipping all the way back in and filling up again. My personal favourite is this one with the smaller hole in. It's really good for your bigger 6mm pellets. So you can put those in and you can either feed the whole quantity in one go, or you can kind of rattle a few out and then carry on fishing again and keep on doing that. And again, it just saves you having to ship all the way back in each time. So one major improvement with these soft CAD pots over the old ones that we've produced are the holes in the bottom. You can see there's 4 quite large holes, not large enough that any bait will come out through them. But if you fill that full of ground bait or any sort of bait that you're going to wedge into there, if you simply put it against the water, it'll actually help the bait to release and you don't have to tap it and make any disturbance on the water. You can put it on the water, hold it there, and the holes will actually help the bait to release out, so no disturbance at all for the fish. One other benefit of the holes in the bottom of the pot are that when you have your pot against the water and let your bait release, it releases it into a really tight column in the water, so all of your bait drops down through the same bit and ends up around your hook bait. If you were to hold your pot above the water and tap it for your bait to come out, which is the old conventional way, it tends to spread about quite a lot and you'll end up with your bait over a big area and you might foul look more fish. So the soft CAD pots, as the name suggests, are really, really soft. They're pole friendly and not going to damage it all when you put it on. There's two simple ways of putting them onto your pole. So you can line it up with the end and literally slot it on to the desired position. So you can have it just a couple of inches from the end of the pole or a little bit further if you want to. The other way of putting them on is if you just take the lid off, you can actually push your thumb up through the middle and it'll open it out. So you can just put it straight onto the point of the pole that you want the pot. So as you can see, nice and pole friendly, and most importantly, really secure. Right, so I'm going to go through exactly which baits I would use with each lid of the pot. So starting with the one with the smaller hole, say this one's perfect for pellets. So today I've got some hard 6mm pellets, so I can just fill those up. One really nice tip with that is before you ship out, they will kind of rattle as you're shipping and you will lose a few pellets. So if you just dunk the tip under the water and wet them, they'll stick to the side of the pot just enough to ship out and they won't come out. But when you upend your pot, you can still, no problem. So that for me is the perfect lid for hard pellets. So moving on to the next lid, we've got the sprinkle one. So I tend to like to take the sprinkle one off before I use it, and it's very good for micro pellets in particular. So I use the small CAD pot and micro pellets conjunction a lot in the winter. So you can go out and you can just tap a few across, catch a fish, or if you don't get a bite within a few minutes, you can tap a few more across. And you can do that three or four times before you have to come in and refill the pot. So that's really good for that style of fishing. Again, very good for maggots doing the same thing, and 4mm pellets as well. So it's nice sized holes, so 4mm pellets, you've got no problem using that. And finally, as I said, no lid at all is another option that you can use. It's got a really hard rim, so it'll hold its shape. So for me, there's two different baits that I'd use like this. One of them's a worm and caster mix. So here I've got some worms, casters, and micro pellets. So I can put those into the pot, and by squeezing it, really doesn't come out very easily at all. So I can chip all the way across to the far bank like that with no chance of it coming out. And then I can just put that on the water surface and that will just come out. And so we've got a clean pot again there. So all your baits down that one same water column, you can drop your rig straight over it and catch a fish. The other combination I'd use with no lid is ground bait. So I'd put in a few of your hook bait to start with, so corn on this occasion. And then I like to use a nice dry ground bait to create cloud. Just fill up the pot and then use your thumb to compress it. So that's not coming out at all now as you're shipping across. But as soon as you put that in the water, because the ground bait's dry in particular, you literally touch the water and it all comes out down the same column. And you've got a dry pot and you can drop your rig straight over that and hopefully catch a fish really quickly. So one pot I haven't spoken about yet is the Mega Soft CAD pot. As you can see, it's huge in comparison even to the largest CAD pot. But it's great for when you haven't got a cupping kit for your pole, so you can use that basically as a cupping kit. Just clip it onto your pole and then take it back off when you're not needing it. Or for when I use it when I'm fishing close in down the edge, when you're feeding loads of bait late in the match, and I actually leave it on the pole. So I might be filling that full of grain bait and corn or grain bait and maggots. So as you can see, you can get a couple of good handfuls of grain bait in there. Do the same thing, just compress it down. And it's a large amount of bait every single cast then as you go in. And if you're fishing for big carp, that's what you want. You want to put in plenty of bait. So the Megasoft CAD pot, another great addition. And with the three normal CAD pots and the Megasoft CAD pot, you've literally got a pot for every single occasion.